Hey there, this is Matt Watridge with Austin, Texas Gardening. This video is all about prepping my plants for a freeze coming up.
The forecast for the night of November the 30th moving into December has some lows between 26 and 28 degrees, so I just wanted to share some of the steps that I've taken to protect my plants from frost damage. This is my olive tree, and I've wrapped it in a layer of burlap over a layer of bubble wrap. And that's the technique that I'm using. So the bubble wrap provides extra added insulation from padding and the air bubbles. Air is just a really great insulator. And then just putting this breathable burlap over it is some of the better prevention steps that have worked for me in the past. So both of these trees should be fine. They're younger trees, so I'm wrapping them, but both of them have a frost tolerance of around 15 degrees, and it's not gonna get that cold. Over here in the garden bed, if you've seen my previous video on harvesting tomatoes and jalapenos, these are the plants that really need the frost protection. So my tomatoes here and my jalapenos, if we can save these plants, then I consider that a total win. And hopefully any other added benefit to just give these plants a soft transition into their dormancy period would be great too. So here in Austin, Texas, we're in zone 8B, which means the minimum temperature is really 10 degrees. The brown turkey fig and the olive tree should be fine. It shouldn't get really lower than 25 degrees. And in our garden bed here, we have tomatoes, jalapenos, and basil, which are all very, very frost sensitive. They can't really handle anything below freezing, which is why we're wrapping them. And some rosemary, which is much more hardy and I'm not too worried about. Now, if you've seen my in-ground garden bed video, you're probably familiar with some of the plants in this backyard garden bed here. We have cabbage, cauliflower, and celery, as well as Swiss chard, which are all hardy winter vegetables, and a peach tree, which has really good frost tolerance. Texas is known for its peaches, so I'm pretty sure this tree would be fine either way, but we decided to wrap it. And we have three little jalapeno plants here, which hopefully will survive.
Well, it's the next morning, and it's pretty cold. It's about 7:40 right now, and there's a lot of frost on the grass. It didn't rain or anything, or snow, I guess. All the roofs have quite a bit of frost on the tops of them. And I didn't wrap the holly or anything, so these leaves I'm sure will be fine. It doesn't look like some of my wildflowers even noticed that it froze, though they put some frost on. And I forgot to wrap the rosemary. I think the rosemary will be okay. It said 25, 26 degrees on weather.com and 27 degrees on the weather app, so I'm not sure how cold it is, but it feels really cold right now. And I'm not gonna take the wrapping off the plants until it heats up a little bit more. I'm almost certain these trees will be fine. The fig tree can survive as low as 15 degrees and the olive tree likewise as low as 15 degrees, so it's not even close to that. But clearly, Their garden beds here are dusted with frost all over. So out here in the backyard, there is a lot more frost. And you can kind of see that it's not taking any real amount of time for sunlight to get this frost melted. I'm sure here in a couple hours, it's probably gonna be 40, 45 degrees. Our burlap, tarp, and bubble wrap seems to have done a good job at protecting our plants for the most part, just at a glance. I see a little bit of cauliflower peeking through right there. Hopefully that's not problematic, but these are hardy winter vegetables. I think they'll be okay at surviving. Hopefully, you know, we'll see what happens. We got our outdoor water spigots wrapped up to prevent any bursts or anything. And yeah, there's just frost everywhere. Like, take a look at this. Nice. We get really excited down here in Texas anytime anything freezes. Oh, that's fun. Okay, well, that's enough. Playing around with the ice. We will come back in a few hours when it heats up a bit.
Well, all of our ice is melted. It's warmed up quite a bit. And I removed our bubble wrap and burlap from the winter garden. And almost everything looks great. My cabbage is here, and that's cauliflower right there. Cabbage, cauliflower, they're doing awesome. And they don't even look that damaged. I have like one dead leaf here. Celery, likewise, it looks a little flatter, just to be honest. It's a little less perky than it was before. Some of this is kind of spread out a little bit. But I think it's going to be okay. The chard, you can't even tell anything happened. It looks exactly the same. However, one thing I was going to say is, well, our peach tree is completely fine. I mean, I wouldn't even be able to tell if it's that damaged. I think most of the leaves it lost were just due to the physical trauma of being wrapped. And I didn't even have enough bubble wrap on it to really do anything. But these jalapenos here are the most frost damaged. You can just tell by looking at them. That level of wilt is not normal. And kind of what we have going on here is just clear frost damage, which isn't surprising. These jalapeno plants I didn't think would survive the frost, so that's okay. Our peach tree over here, really nothing to see. It has no leaves, but let's cut over to the front yard and see what we got.
So bear with me if the audio sounds a little bit different here. I had to redub all of the audio for this section of the video because of the wind. But our front yard bed did super well after being wrapped. You can see this first jalapeno plant here. Those bottom leaves look really normal and healthy, and the top leaves are kind of withered and lighter, kind of like the damaged jalapenos in the backyard. And so our tomato plant here did super well. We only lost two tomatoes, and I think that was just kind of blunt force from the bubble wrap scratching up against it. There's our other tomato, but the whole plant itself has minimal frost damage. It's a super big win. This tomato plant over here, likewise, very little frost damage, and tomatoes are super delicate, so that's a huge win. Also the basil, almost no frost damage, which is super surprising because basil is very, very delicate and sensitive to frost. A rosemary was just fine as well, and the whole front yard bed really did a great job of weathering this frost. And so moving over to our fig tree here, you can very clearly see the frost damage. That leaf there that looks like a claw is not from dehydration. That happened in one night and is very, very clearly frost damage. And so this isn't that big of a deal. Fig trees lose their leaves every winter regardless. We just want to give it a very gentle and slow transition to its dormant period because it's such a small and such a young fig tree.
So today's the next day. And it's almost 8 o'clock, and you can really see what I meant when I said sometimes you have to wait another day to fully assess the frost damage. It is so clear this jalapeno plant is barely hanging on. The tomato plant, on the other hand, looking super. I don't really even see much frost damage. We obviously lost a tomato there and a tomato there, but really, the bubble wrap and the burlap kept it really safe. Over here, similarly, this tomato plant looks like it's doing fairly well. And our jalapeno plant here has almost no frost damage. So compare that to that. The basil, likewise, has a few black spots on it, but really, basil is super delicate and liable to be frost damaged, and it looks pretty good. If we move over here to our fig tree, olive tree's fine. I'm not even gonna talk about the olive tree. The fig tree is about to go dormant. That's very clear to me. We bubble wrapped it, we put burlap on it, and if I compare a shot of the fig tree here and overlay what the fig tree looked like before we wrapped it, you'll see that it's losing all of its leaves. Now again, that's totally fine. The fig tree was gonna go dormant, it was gonna lose all of its leaves anyway, but it's on its way out the door. So let's go to the backyard and see what's going on. So, we're out here in the back, and compared to yesterday, I don't see anything that's taken more damage than the jalapenos. My cauliflower and cabbage has good frost tolerance, it's completely fine. Celery also looks totally healthy, as does the Swiss chard, but our three jalapeno plants here,
each one of them has its own degree of wilt and obvious frost damage.
So I still consider the bubble wrap and burlap method a success. I know that I wasn't able to save everything, but jalapenos are probably the most frost-sensitive thing that I'm growing. The fact that I was able to save the tomatoes, I consider a win. And probably also add a little bit of protection to this one-year-old peach tree. But anyway, I hope these tools are able to equip you guys to protect your plants if you're in zone 7, 8, and 9. And thanks for watching.